Thank you. पद गुरुपाद पद्म निंदा पुरुषो विष्णुपाद अष्टोत्थ भक्ति जीवन जनानंद गोस्वामी महाराज एवं मध्य शिक्षा गुरुपाद संन्यास प्रदाता निंदा पुरुषो विष्णुपाद अष्ट भक्ति वेदांत नारायण गोस्वामी महाराज के चरण कमलों में अनंत कोटि दंडवत प्रणाम करते हुए उनकी हैसियत कृपा की प्रार्थना करता हूँ। आज के सभा के सभापति ओम विष्णुपाद अष्ट भक्ति गोपानंद मान महाराज जी और उन्हीं के साथ अतिथि रूप में और हम लोग का वर्णन करने के लिए जो पधारे हैं, ओम विष्णुपाद अष्ट भक्ति वेदांत भक्ति विकास गोविंद महाराज जी, ओम विष्णुपाद भक्ति प्रियानंद मान महाराज जी एवं पुष्पद भक्ति वेदांत सागर महाराज अन्य पादगण आप सबों के प्रति अनंत कोटि दंडवत प्रणाम और ऐसे कृपा की प्रार्थना करता हूँ। आप लोग आज महाराज जी के साविभाव तिथि में ऐसी कृपा करके हम व्यक्तिगत जनों को हम अयोग्य जनों को उत्साह प्रदान करने के लिए पधारे हैं, इसलिए बदले में हमारे पास कुछ देने को नहीं है। आपकी महिमा जय हो जय हो। आप चिर काल से कैसे हमें उत्साह प्रदान करते रहे, यही प्रार्थना आप वैष्णवगणों के चरणों में है। समय 11 बज चुका है तो जल्दी से जल्दी सभा को आगे बढ़ाया जाए। तो अभी आप लोग समझ में श्रीमती श्याम रानी दीदी हु सो लॉन्ग एक्सपीरियंस एसोसिएट टू गुरुदेव एंड सो मच डीड फॉर गुरुदेव सेवा। एक्चुअली गुरुदेव गेव सो मच हर्ट मर्सी वैजाइट मर्सी से सो मच अब्जॉर्ब टू गुरुदेव सेवा। We are looking this painting Seva Kunja, many painting of our Guru Bhargav. She herself is all. Because Gurudev putting her heart with all mood and bhav and by them came out. Like Krishna's empty flutes putting on heart, on mood, on bhav, and then flute what cannot do. But if Krishna not give on this mood, bhav, then flute is like one dry thing, nuts, wouldn't know any quality, but if go Krishna hand, then that flute can know the stock cloth, ananda heads, wandering room, moving, and everything can make. So like this step, Maharaj gave her so much mercy on us. See what arna, what relax, this thing will distribute to us. So we also can this time hear mood and try to get. So now she will something. Hare Krishna.
And the same unlimited obeisances In the dust of the lotus feet, my most worshipable Shiksha Gurudev, Nichavila Pravishta Om Vishnu Pad, Astotra Sat Sri Srimad, Srila Bhakti Vedanta Narayana Goswami Maharaj. To all of our Guru Varga, all the Sannyasigan, all assembled Vaishnavas and Vaishnavis, and all honored guests. Today is the most auspicious day for us, the appearance of Sri Guru. In Bali, in the late 90s, I asked Srila Gurudev, what is the meaning when we honor Gurudev every day with Astotra Sat Sri Sri? So Gurudev said, Astotra Sata means 108. When you combine 1 and 0 and 8, you get 9. 9 is the highest number, because after 9, again comes 1 and 0. So he said, Sri Guru has the highest number of Sris. Sri means material prowesses. There are 6 material opulences: beauty, wealth, strength, fame. He has all those in completeness. There are 8 mystic potencies. One can reach out and get a fruit from another planet. One can become lighter than an atom. He's full with all those 8 mystic powers, which Sri Narada Muni said is just an insignificant byproduct of his devotion. He has all the spiritual opulences. As we see in the second canto, all the spiritual perfections are personified, and they're all servants of the Lord in the spiritual world. He is the embodiment of all of those. And Sri, meaning all Lakshmis. Sarva Lakshmi Mayi, Srimati Radhika, he's the manifestation of her heart. And Sri, meaning Shriya, the treasure, the secret treasure, or the service of Srimati Radhika. He is the embodiment of that. So this is the meaning when we say Astotra Sat Sri, Srimad Bhaktivedanta Narayana Goswami Maharaj. And who is that Gurudev? He's the manifestation of Sri Vyasadeva. He's the manifestation of Lord Nityananda. He's the manifestation of the heart of Srimati Radhika. Because as Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur said, Sri Guru is the manifestation of Srila Rupa Goswami. In his Sharanagati, Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur has said that. Sripad Madhusudan Maharaj just mentioned the Sacred Clinch painting. So first, when Srila Gurudev ordered me to do that painting, he said, can you paint my heart? Then as the painting was in progress, and we were all together with him in Navadvipa, he said, actually, this is not a manifestation of my heart. It is a manifestation of Rupa Goswami's heart. No, it is a manifestation of Krishna's heart, because he purposely committed some quote-unquote offense so that Srimati Radhika would become angry with him and create that unlimited fire of separation in his heart. So Srila Gurudev is a manifestation of Krishna's heart and Srila Rupa Goswami's heart. So this is our Sri Gurudev. I'd like to share with you a Vyasa Puja Day lecture that Srila Gurudev gave on his own appearance day. He said, we must know the meaning of Guru Puja and Vyasa Puja. It is the same, because Sri Guru is a manifestation of Srila Vyasadeva. Vyasadeva meaning the diameter. From any point in the circumference of a circle, the diameter goes as a straight line through the center and to any other point in the circumference. So diameter is unlimited. So Vyas is taking that central point, Radha and Krishna, and manifesting Radha and Krishna all over the universes. So our Sri Gurudev is a manifestation of that Vyas. I was very fortunate to travel with him on most of his touring over the last 15 years throughout America, South America, Asia, and in all of those places, he manifested the embodiment of knowledge of Vyas, of the entire Guru Parampara. He's the embodiment of Srila Viswanath Chakravarti Thakur, Srila Narottam Das Thakur, our entire Guru Parampara. If you turn that into a body, make a form, that's our Srila Gurudev. So he went around the world and he gave Ramananda Rai Sambandh, Rupa Shiksha, Sanatana Shiksha, the five bhaktis, and bhakti, what is the gradation of bhakti, what is the cause of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's coming, or why did Krishna come in the form of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu's teaching, the Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, the 11th canto, Krishna preaching to Uddhava, and the deep moods of Uddhava coming to Vrindavan and hearing Radharani speaking to a bumblebee, all that Srila Gurudev implanted on the planet. If a conditioned soul like me speaks, I'm giving you syllables which have some information about the reality. If a Raghunuga Bhakta speaks Parikata, he's giving you a shadow. If somebody like Srila Gurudev, who's a personal associate of Srimati Radhika in Goloka Vrindavan, a Raghunuga Bhakta, speaks Parikata, he's actually giving the seed of the reality. So as he went for the past 15 years all over the world, he was planting seeds of the actual reality. Even when he called on us to speak, he would sit there and say nothing sometimes, and he would call on us to speak. But what was really happening was the frame atoms were emanating from all the pores of his body, and from his glands was coming Shabda Brahma, spiritual reality. So he planted seeds of that all over the world. So on this Vyasa Puja lecture, Srila Gurudev said that Vyasadeva, without Vyasadeva, what Gurudev is a manifestation of, he said everything would be nothing. Vyasadeva explained the Gayatri Mantra in his first verse of Srimad Bhagavatam. We wouldn't have any of the scriptures if it wasn't for Vyasadeva. Then Gurudev began telling some secrets. He said, I've never told this before. I'm going to tell you a secret about Gayatri. Because Guru gives Diksha, and we read in Bhakti Prasamrita Sinda Bindu, that when Guru gives mantra, he's putting himself in the mantra. He's not different from the mantra. Especially Guru Gayatri, Tana Guru Prachodayat, but in all mantras, he's present there. So what's happening when he gives Gayatri Mantra? He said, you should know who is Gayatri. Who is Gayatri? It seems that Gayatri is the consort of Brahma. But because Srimad Bhagavatam is ultimately the swarup of Srimati Radhika and her glories, when Vyasadeva explained the Gayatri to the first verse of Srimad Bhagavatam, and his representatives, our acharyas, gave the deep meaning, the first meaning being Krishna the Supreme Lord, then Krishna of Vrindavan, then Radha Krishna, then higher than that Radha, then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who is Krishna, covered by the moon of Radharani. So Gayatri Mantra, Krishna wanted to give, or Vyasadeva wanted to give, not only knowledge, Gurudev said that is not sufficient, but he wants to give the weeping moons of the gopis who can weep for Krishna. So he said Gayatri was actually, Krishna told Yogamaya that Gayatri, I want to have a parakeet mood with Gayatri. She is my gopi beloved. So give her, because all the other gopis were given to gopis, ostensibly, give her to Brahma. So Gayatri never loved Brahma, she only loved Krishna. So she became in that way Krishna's Parathya beloved. So Gurudev said, I never said this secret before, but I'm telling it to you now. She is the maidservant of Srimati Radhika, or Radhika herself, manifest as her maidservant. So he said, so through this, Sri Guru is giving you that relationship with Sri Krishna. So this is the most fortunate, most blessed day for us, his followers, nay, for the entire universe. Before I end, I would just like to show this very beautiful Vyasa Puja magazine in honor of Srila Gurudev and also manifestation of Srila Gurudev in the form of this magazine. We have to thank Vaijayanti Maladini, Amal Krishna Prabhu, Shanti Dasi, Manjuri Dasi, Vichitra Dasi, and all of their team for tirelessly working for months and the last week not sleeping at all so that we can get this so lovely magazine on this very day. So by the mercy of the GVP book sponsorship, we'll be giving it out freely to all of the honored guests, especially the honored speakers. Lord Prema,
transcendental personality like Srila Gurudev. But
because Srila Gurudev did come, and he did pick me up from the ocean of material suffering that I was in. I do have some experience of his unbounding love. His love was unbelievable. He himself once said, "There's no one in this world who can love like me. Selfless love, I can give like no one else can give." And I know, I think we all here experienced that. Srila Gurudev had a way of coming into our lives, and he would just come, and he would just smile, and he would just steal our hearts and put them in his pocket, and then he would run. And we were running after him, going, "What happened? Where's my heart? What?" But this is important, because now Srila Gurudev has appeared, and he's disappeared on this mundane material platform, because this mundane material platform is temporary. The eternal spiritual world is our home. Sri Vrindavan Dham is our home. But this is Drishyaman Prakash. This is not Prakash or Apakash Vrindavan. Our real home is Apakash Vrindavan, which is the dimension which Srila Gurudev is now. Don't think for anything else. Don't ask for anything else. This is what you must become one-pointed at and ask for. Nothing else. Just like Prabhupada always said, ask for $1,000,000, then your $1 problems will be taken care of. So this is it. Ask for Radha-dasya, then your housing problem will be taken care of. Your financial problem will be taken care of. You know, your marriage problems, whatever it is that you think you have, the problem is not a problem. The only problem he taught us was, where is Radha? Where is Krishna? How can I serve them? And then he gave us the goal, and he gave us the relationship. You're my darling daughter. You're my little sister. You're my aspiring disciple. Relationship, intimate relationship. And he made us all feel like we're all very special. We all have a relationship with him. Every single one of us, unique individual. He's capable of that kind of love with every single disciple. Not just the ones who are traveling with him, no. Every single disciple, even those who maybe didn't even meet him yet. And on the external platform, he is not a mundane material person. This means it's an offense to the holy name if we think he's a mundane person and we can't have a relationship with him now. No, we have a transcendental, every opportunity is there for relationships. And he gave us the process. Follow Rupa Raghana. Become the selfless servant of Sri Guru. Just like he did, just like the whole Guru market did. Now he's disappeared. We can't be thinking, "Oh, I'm going to print this book so I can have a darshan of Gurudev. Oh, I get to distribute so many books, so I get to do this, so I'm going to have a darshan. I get to smile." No, now we have to think, "Oh, now I must work hard. I must do everything even harder than before, because I want to get the moon centering his heart that will give me the qualification to actually enter the spiritual world and be with him forever and assist him in his service to Satchinanda Nohari and Sri Sri Radha Krishna. This is his gift. What a gift. Jai. Please forgive all my offenses I may have committed to anyone with my body, words, or mind, please. I desire everyone's mercy. Jai."
Very sweet how Gurudev's words in Sri Lanka distribute to us. Now, Srimati Sri Manjari Devi Dasi, who is a Iskcon temple maybe, or she is the one who are in this Rupa Goswami conference, and she also so much Sami Gurudev, may Prince Gu please translate. She should come and short time she also offer her Pushpanjali. Hare Krishna. And after this, Pushpan Janaki Didi, she's from India. You are so ready because before and on, then we come, then one singular time we can save.
I didn't even realize what was happening. But Vrindavan Balasi says he opens his heart. So years later, when I was once in Mathura, I had a chance to ask him. I said, I can't understand Vipralamba. I hate it. I just don't like it. What's so good about Radharani being separated from Krishna or Krishna being separated from Radharani? It's intolerable. Why is it glorified so much? And Maharaj says, you don't understand Vipralamba. He said, this is very important. You must understand it. He said that when Radharani is with Krishna, they know nothing else. They're not aware of what their pastime is. They're just absorbed in each other. And for them, there's no time. It's just their interaction with one another. And so he said that they're not aware of what's happening. They're not even aware of themselves. He said, but afterwards, when Radharani is separated from Krishna, then she remembers everything. He said, really slowly, everything. And so I was thinking about this, that at this time, Maharaj is giving us the opportunity to remember everything. All the details come back.
So, Puspat Pussi Mandi Mandi Devi Dasi. About separation. Because really, who are not Rupanus, they know except this Vipradam. They're thinking all when meeting. But Krishna also accepts this thing. Saying in Krishna, since you are here to my Katha, Nam, Gun, Rup, Lila, then you feel more close to me, even close to me. So Vipradasur and all gopis, they are also something fair to this separation. So Vipralamba Bhav is our Guru Gaurusvan Bhajan. Our God Kisodas Bhav or Raghunath Goswami Guru Goswami, they are doing Bhajan in Vipralamba Bhav. Othai go frame by Radhira. So how people, ordinary person of this Bhav, if no is accept this step, Guru Gaurusvan is step devotee. Asam Asutad Bhav Gambhira Chitan, Kutasyana Simhura Sasyabhaga. Because without Vipranam, Milan is not any meaning, no any chase. Nabina Vipranam. Many things we explain. Now Sri Janaki Mataji, she also long time, like Gurudev's heart, like life, too much attached to Gurudeva. This is good, this is the one. Part of bhakti is so much attached to your Guru. And by that attachment, you go to there. You don't have to do so much. This is
Sana. confident. Oh, we have grounded in the religion. उनकी जो एक विशेषता हम संसारी लोगों की विषय नहीं कह सकते हूँ कि समस्त संसार की आसक्तियों छुड़ा के जीवन में परिवर्तन लाकर राधा दास्यम की ओर छोड़ देना उनकी बड़ी प्रमुख विशेषता है। कैसा कैसा हम लोगों का जीवन था और कैसा उन्होंने बना दिया। मैं ये जानती हूँ सर्वप्रथम गुरुदेव से मैं बंबई में मिली, उस समय मैं इस्कॉन में थी और इस्कॉन के गुरुकुल की प्रिंसिपल वहां मेरे मन में बहुत प्रश्न उठते थे। स्वामी महाराज की पुस्तक पढ़ते और भी बहुत प्रश्न उठते थे और पूछने से वो लोग कहते थे नारायण महाराज हैं वो आएंगे वो बताएंगे। तो मेरे मन में बड़ी जिज्ञासा हुई है नारायण महाराज कौन है जिसके मेरे प्रश्नों का उत्तर वो ही दे सकते हैं। तो वहां पर तो अपना इलाज कराने आते थे हिंदू जहां हॉस्पिटल में उनका चेकअप वगैरह होता था इस फॉर्म में ही ठहरते थे। तो इस जिज्ञासा के वश में होकर के मैं उनसे किसी प्रकार से मिलने के लिए गई। मिलकर वो बड़े प्रसन्न हुए, मुझे भी बहुत अच्छा लगा और फिर उनसे मैंने कुछ प्रश्न किए। वो प्रश्न और वो उनका मुझे आज तक याद है। उसके बाद में इस्कॉन में मेरा मन नहीं लगा, मैंने कहा जिन प्रश्नों से ये उत्तर दे नहीं सकते नारायण महाराज के पास पूछते हैं तो मैं सीधी उन्हीं के पास क्यों ना जाऊं, यहाँ रहने की मुझे क्या जरूरत है। तो गुरुकुल के प्रिंसिपल का कॉल और वहां की सब छोड़ करके मैं वहां से सीधे वृंदावन आ गई गुरुदेव के पास और उनकी शिक्षाओं से उनसे मिलकर उनसे गुरु संबंध प्राप्त करके मुझे लगा जैसे संसार दावानल मलिनलों का राणा एकारों के घन घनत्वम। तो संसार का जो दावानल है वो तो एक चीज है लेकिन भक्ति के संसार में आकर के भी हम भटकते हैं, हमें पता नहीं लगता हम कौन सा रास्ता पकड़े। गुरुदेव ने वही दिशा निर्देश किया, लक्ष्य की ओर इंगित किया, केवल बताया ही नहीं कि राधा दास्य तुम्हारा लक्ष्य है, उन्होंने ये भी उसकी प्रणाली भी बताई, उसको किस तरह से प्राप्त करना है ये भी बताया और एक एक मैं उनके उपदेशों के विषय में क्या कहूँ जो राधा दास्य किस प्रकार प्राप्त करना है और उसके विषय में जो उन्होंने ग्रंथ लिखे हैं, ग्रंथों के माध्यम से अपने स्वयं के वाणी के माध्यम से उन्होंने जिस प्रकार से हम लोगों को समृद्ध किया है उसका उपकार उसका ऋण तो शायद जन्मों जन्मों तक नहीं चुका होगी। आज मैं अभी बोलने की स्थिति में नहीं हो पा रही हूँ, उनको संभाल नहीं पा रही हूँ इसलिए आप लोग मुझे क्षमा करेंगे। हाँ उनके कुछ उपदेश हैं गुरु निष्ठा है अन्य अभिलाष में बिना कोई वास्तविक सेवा नहीं कर सकता। श्री नाम में रुचि होना ही परम श्रेय रुचि है। राधा दास से पूर्ण लक्ष्य करके राधा दासी होना ये गौड़ीय वैष्णव का प्रमुख लक्ष्य है। रूपानंद के आश्रय में इन सब कुछ उनके उपदेशों को याद करके आज के दिन और उस वक्त पालन करने की हम चेष्टा करेंगे। यही मेरा विचार है, मैं ऐसा सोचती हूँ और मैं इतना चिंता नहीं है अपना वक्तव्य समाप्त करती हूँ। उनके गुणों के विषय में तो मेरे को में शक्ति नहीं है वर्णन करना। एक एक के हृदय में उन्होंने प्रेम
प्रेम में बोला नहीं जाता, मौन में ही समझ लिया जाता है। बोलता तो वही है जब खाली होता है, जब खिचड़ी पक जाती है तो फिर फटफट फटक आवाज नहीं होती, और जब तक कच्चा रहता है तब तक उसमें आवाज होता रहता है। जो उस चीज को अनुभव के वास्तव में गुरु जनों का उनका उपकार को महाराज ने जो दिया वो वाणी से कहा नहीं जा सकता, तो सब संवेद है, केवल अनुभव किया जा सकता है अभिव्यक्त। दर्शन नहीं रहा लेकिन उसको हम भुलाएं कैसे, उनका बोलना, उनका चलना, उनका देखना, उनका हंसना, ये भुला नहीं पा रहे, उसी में उनका दर्शन है। क्योंकि जहां पर उनको हमें भूल जाएंगे, उनका हंसना चलना बोलना वही हमारे लिए मृत्यु होगी, वही हमारे लिए मदद होगा। लेकिन वो कुछ ऐसी लीला करेंगे जो हर क्यों उनको याद करे, वो कैसे बोलते, कैसे चलते, कैसे देखते थे, क्या उनको उपदेश था। और यदि स्मृति है तो साक्षात्कार है, दर्शन है, और यदि भूल गए स्मृति तो फिर दर्शन हो जाते। इसलिए गुरु जन ऐसा दर्शन नहीं होते, वो अपना कुछ ऐसा अनुभव रख जाते हैं, रोते भी लगते दुख बीरा करता भी उन सबको याद कर करके जी लेते, क्योंकि ऐसे तो करते करते हम उनके काले के बिना रह सकती है, हमें काला हर वस्तु से चीड़ है लेकिन दुष्टा के दर्द कथा है। ऐसे गुरुजन इस पीड़ा की अवस्था में उनकी जो कथा, उनकी जो महिमा, उनका जो ग्रंथ आदि है उन्हीं के रूप में हमारे सामने प्रकट है, और वो कभी हमसे अलग नहीं हो सकते, का संबंध हमारे साथ लिखते हैं। चाहे भले हम कितना भी तरह तरह चटपटा रहे हैं लेकिन उसमें उनका अनुभव होता रहेगा, एक अप्राकृत वस्तु की विशेषता। अभी कुछ बात सौनक प्रभु जी होया, इस सौनक प्रभु एंड इफ सौनक प्रभु वी लेट देन नाउ किशोरी मोहन प्रभु कैन कम अ बिटवीन 5 to 7 minutes because he has maybe 20 speakers. I want every person get chance, opportunity, so 5 minutes offer her is Pushpanjali. So it should come. Then you take you, okay? When Sonak Prabhu then. So 5 minutes or maximum 7 minutes. But try to 5 minutes, you get bonus.
Sudanam in your heart.